Hello students, this is R. Kishama from IIT Shore. We are going to study question number 3.5 from Rado. A thin wire ring of radius R has an electric charge Q. What will be the increment of the force stretching the wire if a point charge Q0 is placed at the ring's center? Now, this is ring. Total charge Q is distributed along its circumference. And this is charge Q0 placed at the center. And this angle is d theta. We consider small portion dl of the ring and the radius is r. Now, charge per unit length dq equal to q divided by 2 pi r. So, charge on portion dl equal to charge per unit length divide multiplied by length of the portion in consideration, that is q divided by 2 pi r times dl. Now, arc upon radius equal to angle. So, we write in place of dl r d theta. So we get charge on portion dl as r d theta times q divided by 2 pi r, which is equal to q d theta divided by 2 pi, and we assume it as dq. Now force on this portion due to charge q0 at the center is equal to f equal to q0 times dq divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. We put the value of dq as q d theta divided by 2 pi. So we get q0 times q d theta divided by 2 pi times 4 pi epsilon naught r square, which is equal to q0 d theta divided by 8 pi square epsilon naught r square. Suppose this is equation number 1. Now we consider portion dl. It's in large view. So here tension is in this direction and we divide this angle in two parts, so d theta by 2, and this is also d theta by 2, and this is radius, this will be tangent, so this angle will be 90 degree, and here this angle will be d theta by 2, and this angle is already given as d theta by 2. These are alternate angles, and so we get this angle also d theta by 2. So we take the components of this tension, so t sine d theta by 2 in this direction, t cos d theta by 2 in this direction, similarly here t cos d theta by 2 in this direction and t sine d theta by 2 in this direction. So t cos d theta by 2 here and t cos d theta by 2 here will cancel out, and t sine d theta by 2 and t sine d theta by 2 will get added up. So we write it here the same thing. Consider end points of the portion dl. Components of t are t cos d theta by 2 and t sin d theta by 2. Obviously t cos d theta by 2 will cancel out and t sin d theta by 2 will add up. Thus total tension is 2 t sin d theta by 2. If angle is small, then instead of sin d theta by 2 we write just d theta by 2. So 2 will cancel out and we will get tension as t dash equal to 2t into d theta by 2, which is equal to t d theta. Now this is also one force, so we create equation number 1 and equation number 2. So we get t d theta equal to q0 d theta divided by 8 pi square epsilon naught r square. d theta will cancel out and we will be left with t equal to q0 divided by 8 pi square epsilon naught r square. Here this angle is shown in detail, so if this is the half of the angle, this is x, this is x, so here this will also be x. Now this x plus y will be 90 degree and z plus y will also be 90 degree, so we will get z equal to x and x is this angle, so that is why this, if this angle is d theta by 2, so this angle will also be d theta by 2. Hence the answer. Thank you.